Ah, the beautiful alarm clock that makes you want to punch the person who's closest to you. But, you know, you don't want to lose your job, so you got to get up. I usually start my day by freshening up my spirit, and I get that through reading the Word of God, because without Him, the day is a super drag. And immediately, I go ahead and freshen up my room, open up the blinds. A lot of the times, I'll open up my windows as well before I even go and hit the showers. And actually, I like making my bed before I actually leave for work. So whenever I come home, it feels nice to go into a bed that's already made.
So every morning, I never forget to take my vitamins. I know some people take their vitamins without water, and I just think that's nasty, and you need some help.
Finally, my room is clean, my bed is made, my backpack is packed with my work laptop, my change of clothing, and my gym shoes, and I'm ready to rock and roll. I usually like to start my day on the rooftop checking all my emails, but today it was raining extra hard, and obviously I'm not gonna be sitting out here where my laptop can get wet, but it was still beautiful.
Fortunate that it's raining right now, but it's still very beautiful outside. So now I'm gonna go ahead, make my coffee, and then head straight to the facility.
So this was the fit of the day, semi-casual, let's get it.
Whenever I'm at home, I like to make my coffee fresh, and I'm gonna show you guys how I make it right here with a press.
This process, you know, you have a regular coffee press, and then I have my electric. I feel like there's enough water in there. I'm just gonna be making one drink and go ahead and close the top of my kettle. It tells me that the water in there is 63 degrees, so I'll go ahead and heat it up to 212 degrees Fahrenheit. As you can see, the temperature is rising. You can hear the water boiling in there. Once it hits 212, then I can start putting in the coffee. So to prep it, I use 2 scoops of coffee. So it's finally 212 degrees, so we can go ahead and take our electric kettle and add it to the coffee. And then you just let it sit for 4 minutes with the lid on top.
It's been 5 minutes now, so now you just press it down and then it will separate all the grains from the actual coffee.
Once it's separated, you can just go ahead and start pouring it in. And just like that, you have one of the best tasting coffees.
Now that I've had my coffee, it's time to head straight to the office. You know, first things first, gotta unlock my car, whip in the little Audi. Yeah, this car is fantastic on gas, so if you're not trying to spend a lot on gas, I highly recommend getting this 1.8 liter engine. The one thing I don't like about Baltimore though is all the lights, but once you get past all of this, heading straight to the office is actually a breeze here in Maryland, and yeah.
Okay, so I grew some hair, yes. I started the video, but I couldn't record at the office, so I was like, okay, I gotta break it down for them somehow. So, today's the day. So when it comes to being an electrical engineer on the job site, because of what I do, I can't really take you guys to the office, but I'm gonna break down what happens on a typical work day. So first off, right, the number one thing you'll do when you get to work is you wanna check your email. You're going to check your email to see if there's any updates to any messages that you sent out the day before, or if your manager or other members of your project groups are inviting you to Teams meeting for that day. You're gonna have to check your email first thing first and get on top of it. Although you're an electrical engineer, you're gonna spend a lot of times in team meetings, okay? That's one thing that it doesn't matter if you're an electrical, if you're a software engineer, if you're a mechanical engineer, your Teams calls are going to be your best friend. You're gonna know like the back of your hand, you're always going to be on it. There hasn't been a single work day that went by that I did not go into a Teams meeting, or two, go into an in-person Teams meeting in an office with other group members.
But because, you know, obviously you guys can't see inside the office for the lunch today, I actually came to get a kebab, Moab. I forgot how you say the name of the place, but this is what I'm gonna have for lunch, and it's amazing, and it's challah meat, for any of you guys that know what that means. So I'm gonna go get some right now.
Secure the bag. This is what I'm going to be eating. That's tiki chicken, which is like boneless. And then I have my salad and the little sauce that comes with it. And as well, it comes with a little bread. Let me grab it for you. There. I'm not going to lie. It's busting. I never heard of kebabs
until I came here to Baltimore, and by the facility, my manager showed me this place, and it is off the chain. So I highly recommend, if you ever come to Maryland and you want to try something new, come to this place.
A big thing they don't stress enough in college is that you need to be very proficient in MATLAB, right? When you're in college as an electrical engineer, you do take some MATLAB classes, computer science one, but they don't tell you how necessary it is that you be very proficient, because almost all the stuff we do, even when it comes to testing, we have to use MATLAB. I've heard there's some departments that some electrical engineers use Python, but whenever you're taking data from boomers, a lot of the work are straight from MATLAB. And the final part of my workplace is pretty much, you know, when it comes to testing build things, you're actually gonna be working on hardware and you're actually going to be testing. This isn't something my company made. This is a buck converter that I made in college, and I love hands-on. So there's even electrical engineers that are fully on site all the time, and they have to, you know, they do a bunch of different testing on what the devices that my company makes. These projects could take a year, 2 years before you see the end results for the most part. And it varies. I'm not always working on MATLAB. I'm not always working on testing. It's very fluid. And once you go in, you'll think you're going in only specifically on one thing. But as an electrical engineer, you gotta be willing to be diverse. And you're gonna pick up so many skills with all the different fields in your specific company.
Meet up with one of the other engineers. We come in usually groups of three. Sometimes if one can't show up, there's gonna be two of us. And every Tuesdays and Thursday, I have soccer training in the afternoon. But today is Wednesday, so I don't have training today. So I'm just gonna be in the gym.
After sitting down all day in the office, I always come down and do a little bit of legs, get the blood flowing down there, because I haven't moved it all day. And then I end my workout with a 1 mile run.
Right now I'm walking at 2.6 to cool down. He works with me too.
Time I'm finally home, and the one thing that's amazing is coming home to a nicely made bed.
As you can see, since I already completed my bed this morning, I come back to my desk. It's very simple and clean, so that I can now shower and just go to bed. It's time. The Uzumaki. If you don't have this, if you want to buy this for me, I am selling it for $50,000. If you can cuff that up, I'll give it to you with both hands.